گردهمایی در کنگره آمریکا در آستانه نوروز. فراخوان به بازگشت فوری مجاهدین به اشرف. 15 مارس 2013، 25 اسفند 1391. ایلیانا روزلهتینن، رئیس زیر کمیته خاورمیانه. کوین بریدی، نماینده ارشد در کمیته راه حل‌ها، معاون رهبری اکثریت کنگره. شیلا جکسون لی، عضو کمیته قضایی، عضو ارشد کمیته امنیت ملی. رندی وبر، عضو کمیته خارجی. گرت شرمن، نایب رئیس زیر کمیته تروریست. فورتن بری، عضو کمیته بودجه. جان کارتر، عضو کمیته بودجه. تری ریدل، عضو کمیته خارجی. ترنت فرانکس، عضو ارشد کمیته قوای مسلح، عضو کمیته قضایی. استیو استکمن، عضو کمیته خارجی. کرن بس، عضو کمیته خارجی. سرهنگ وسلی مارتین، فرمانده حفاظت اشرف. سرهنگ مک گلاسکی، فرمانده حفاظت اشرف. پروفسور آلن گرسون، مشاور پیشین هیئت آمریکا در ملل متحد.
Thank you so very much. Thank you for this great opportunity to be here at such a meaningful event as we gather here today in honor of the Iranian New Year. I can't think of a more appropriate time to talk about the plight of the residents at Camp Ashraf. As you know, everyone here knows what happened in Camp Liberty last month. It has a terrorist attack that killed several freedom-loving individuals, peaceful members of the community. It left many more wounded. And this act, as we know, was reprehensible, but it was preventable. I joined my friend and colleague, and your friend as well, Judge Ted Poe of Texas, in introducing House Resolution 89 that does two important things among many. It condemns this terrible terrorist attack that left some dead and many more wounded, and it calls for an immediate and safe return of all of the residents currently in Camp Liberty back to Camp Ashraf. This attack demonstrated that the living conditions of the residents are being threatened. It demonstrated that their safety is in jeopardy as the threat of another attack by the Quds force could be imminent. And that is our greatest fear, that the worst is not over, that more could be coming. And not only that, but it demonstrates that the United Nations and the Iraqi government have not lived up to their promises. Their promise was to ensure the safety for all of those residents in Camp Ashraf who've now been relocated to Camp Liberty. So it is time for us in the United States to show the United Nations and the Iraqi government what it means to keep one's word. We need to help facilitate the prompt and the safe return of all of the residents from Camp Liberty back to Camp Ashraf, where they can be better protected. It has been their home. They deserve to be back home. And this is an urgent humanitarian situation, and time is of the utmost essence. Let us not run the risk of being here again at the next Iranian New Year, lamenting our lack of action. So I have been urging my colleagues in a speech that I gave, Congressman Cotton also spoke, Judge Poe has spoken, so many others have spoken, urging our colleagues in joining me in calling for Judge Poe's bill to be debated on the House floor as soon as possible. I think we have my congressman, my colleague from Florida, who's just joined us. Come on over here, Trey. Come on over and say hello. And Trey Raydell from the west coast of, I think of it as the west coast of Miami. And when I came in here, Trey, they had pointed out right there where those young men and women are two portraits, Mansoor and Hamid. And these are two individuals who just recently passed away from the injuries of that terrible terrorist attack. And I know that they were friends of many of you here today. So I am here just like Trey is to express our condolences to you on the deaths of your friends, and that we will continue to work hard so that we don't have these sad remembrances of individuals like Mansoor and Hamid, who were the future leaders of a free Iran. But also juxtaposed with that sad memory is this hopeful and enlightened memory, which is the hope for a new year, symbolizing prosperity, symbolizing a green for life, garlic for health, and that is the blessing of a new year. So we have a bittersweet day today where we mourn the loss of two great men and others who sadly passed before them. At the same time, we renew the universe with the promise of a new year. And may this new year bring about a positive change for all of the people in Iran and all of the Iranian exiles. And we hope that soon the residents of Camp Liberty will again be in Camp Ashraf. And ladies and gentlemen, we have been blessed in our election cycle to have some outstanding members of the United States Congress now. And this gentleman who's next to me is such a friend of the Iranian American community. He's on our Foreign Affairs Committee. He's a true fighter for peace, for democracy, for prosperity, and a helpful friend. Ladies and gentlemen, Trey Raydell.
Quite frankly, I had no idea I was going to speak right now. And I love how Ellie puts you on the spot. Thank you all so much for having us today. As a member of Foreign Affairs and as a servant to this great country of ours, I'm a servant to you. But think about the generations of Iranian Americans that have come here, through the generations and then after the revolution in the 1980s. It is a culture that has come here and been tremendously successful in a way that we have shared our cultures, melded together, and you have tremendously successful business people. I'm a firm believer that a more stable, safe Middle East, and when we go and look at Iran, is a more stable and safe United States. And that is why we must work together in the name of liberty for all. That said, I'm excited to meet as many people as I can. Thank you. I've traveled extensively all over the world, and I hope one day that I do get to go to a free Iran and travel, and maybe we can share, have cultural exchanges there as well. Nowruz Mubarak!
Before I say anything, although you may have done it already, you see, I am battle-worn and battle-worked. I have stuck by you and been by you as we have gone from State Department to courts of law and back again. And I want you to give Allen an enormous applause because he stood in there with the writ of mandamus. While we can petition as a member of the bar, a lawyer, I understand that we need the foot soldiers in the courthouse demanding justice. So my words are simply as we celebrate this new year, that after we fought so hard for first the transfer of our loved ones, your loved ones, to Camp Liberty, and now to see that the T-wall, 17,750, has been removed, it doesn't make any sense, and we will fight to get the kind of safety and security for those in Camp Liberty. We will not rest. I am not on the Foreign Affairs Committee, but you would not know it. I thank the members of that committee for being so kind. And so as quickly as I could, as you well know, I, too, am a member and a co-sponsor and a proud co-sponsor of H-Res 89. We want it now. We want to get it passed, and I'll help to work get it passed. We will work with all of you to protect them, to get them good health care, to make sure that we save their lives. So I close by simply saying, when we think of a new year in the United States, more than 3 months ago, as Americans, we think of a new birth, a new opportunity, a fresh start. And I know that I will learn that the blessings of Nowruz would have a similar thought of getting us going into a new way, in a new day. And as we leave this place today, we should, as we look out into the bright sun of a free America, we should never forget our friends who are standing strong in Camp Liberty and places elsewhere because Iran does not welcome them and they're not able to come to a nuclear-free or a democratic Iran. We must never, as the sun shines brightly in America over a democratic and free nation, I beg of you, as you leave this place with a new year and a new opportunity, let us commit ourselves that we will not, never on our watch, forget those in Camp Liberty who are reaching to us to carry their message and to set them free. Thank you all very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Nowruz Mubarak.
Hello, it's good to be with you again. I'm Brad Sherman from California's best named city, Sherman Oaks. I'd like to wish everyone here Eid Nowruz Mubarak. For 17 years, I've served on the Foreign Affairs Committee. I'm now the chief Democrat on the subcommittee that deals with terrorism and nonproliferation. And for all of those 17 years, I've been dedicated to democracy in Iran. I want to commend former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton for making the right decision in removing the MEK from the lists of foreign terrorist organizations last September. Would have been nice if this decision had been made earlier, but ultimately the right decision was made. We are all aware of what happened on February 9th when dozens of rockets were fired into the camp formerly known as Camp Liberty, where 3,100 people live. And we saw that seven, and I believe that we may have had even someone else who died of their wounds, but seven unarmed residents were killed, more were wounded. And I'm particularly concerned because at the camp they had these concrete T-walls, over 1,700 of them, that were around the trailers that were designed to protect the residents if, God forbid, there was an explosion, because this was not an unpredictable act. And those 1,700 T-walls were removed from around the trailers. If they had remained, fewer lives would have been lost. And it is time for all of those who are concerned with human rights in the world to ask the Iraqi government why concrete structures designed to protect people from blasts were removed in the months prior to when rockets containing explosives were fired into the camp. Now, we know that the Hezbollah brigades, an Iranian government-affiliated group, has claimed responsibility for the attack and warned that others would follow. One of the great facts that recommends the MEK for our review is the fact that, as far as I can tell, it is the organization most feared and hated by the Iranian government. The State Department rightfully condemned these attacks in the strongest terms. And last month, I joined with Congressman Ted Poe. Ted and I are the chief Republican on the one hand, chief Democrat on the Terrorism and Nonproliferation Subcommittee, and several of our colleagues, to introduce House Resolution 89 to condemn the attacks and to call on the administration to take strong steps to protect the residents of the camp. And, of course, the terrorists... The terrorists who launched those rockets need to be brought to justice. Camp Huria seems to have been designed more as a prison camp than as a camp for those who are refugees. We have to ensure that the Iraqi government takes meaningful steps to provide better security and better living conditions. And I look forward to celebrating Nowruz with you next year, when we will hopefully be celebrating a new regime in Tehran.